Hello, I'm Clay Nickel, Chief Investment Officer and Strategist with Arvest Wealth Management, and I want to welcome you to our August Viewpoint video. We continue to see this ongoing debate about whether or not the U.S. is currently in a recession. And again, it's an election year, so a lot of this is very politically motivated. From the economic sense and what this means for investors, the debate around the recession or not recession is somewhat academic. As we look at this, we're not seeing the signs of a classic or traditional recession. Things like increasing and elevated job loss, a reduction in consumer spending, a reduction in business investment, and then, of course, a reduction or a hit to corporate cash flows, which would affect both earnings outlook and then also balance sheet health for the companies that we might look to invest in. So that type of classic or traditional recession is still a ways off. We would anticipate 2023, possibly even going into 2024. In the midst of all this, we just received jobs data or employment data, the non-farm payrolls, that showed a net gain of over 500,000 jobs for the month of July. Compare this to the consensus economic estimate for 250,000 net new jobs, and it was a surprisingly positive jobs figure. And we continue to see resilience and even strength in the labor market. Could even say that this is pointing to an overheating of the labor market. What this means for some of the inflation outlook is that it will remain relatively elevated. The Federal Reserve is fully in inflation fighting mode, which means that they'll continue to act aggressively to arrest these inflationary pressures. What this means is we could see rate hikes that go on longer than most market participants are currently anticipating, where right now the estimation is the Fed will stop raising rates and possibly even cut rates in 2023. Our concern for some time has been that the Fed will continue to hike rates into 2023 and would hold them at those elevated levels instead of cutting in the face of some economic pressures or an economic downturn. And so that is the risk that now this jobs number that shows a hotter jobs market just continues to feed that concern for us. And that is not in market expectations. So there could be pain in 2023, both in terms of the economy and for market participants, but we're not necessarily seeing those drivers right now. We continue to retain an asset allocation that is close to benchmark targets, although we are allowing risk assets to remain slightly below our strategic allocations. With this, it does have implications for different types of investors. If you have a long time horizon, if you are still accumulating wealth, if you have a multi-generational focus, we're not sure that you need to do a whole lot with a portfolio other than some tweaks for rebalancing here and there. But there are some implications for retirees or those who are on the cusp of retirement, and in particular, within that segment, those that are going to be relying on income or draws from a portfolio to support their living expenses. What we would recommend, given the rally that occurred in both the stock and bond market in July, we think it would be prudent for those that are receiving income from a portfolio to potentially raise some cash for living expenses, somewhere from 6 to 12 months of what they might normally spend over the course of that time period. This doesn't mean that you are going drastically risk off. We think that would be a mistake. We do still think that those asset allocation targets are important to remain close to. But again, if you are relying on income from a portfolio, we think raising a little bit of cash now so that you can spend from a low volatility, safe asset, instead of potentially having to take draws if we see further market declines, is something that would be sensible. With that, we've included some additional details in our written viewpoint, which was published earlier this month. We encourage you to refer to that. It also goes through some of the nuances of what's going on now economically, and then also some additional details on stock and bond market outlook. Additionally, would invite all of you to join us for our monthly viewpoint webcast. Typically occurs on the second Thursday of every month. You can get additional details on that from your local Arvest Wealth Management team. And so we look forward to helping you in any way we can through those webcasts. Again, those are interactive, and you can ask questions directly of our portfolio management and analyst staff.